Ladies and gentlemen, we are here today at the Lumiri of Ayika's Palace here in Ayikaole in Okitipupa, local government area of Ondo State. We are here to be part of the Ayikaole celebration, and today at the palace there's going to be a lecture delivered by the seasoned professor of linguistics and the Kalaswe of Apoiland, Oba Sunday Amosinga. The title of the lecture that the Royal Father will be delivering is The Synergy Between Education and Community Development. I wish you happy viewing.
Today we have packaged this program so that we will know what education is, what education means, and the importance of it. And today we have invited no other person to salute him respectfully to take us through, to teach us and to impart us on the importance of education in our economic development, in the growth of our town, Ayikaole, Ayika Kingdom.
It's a thing of joy. I'm very grateful to God Almighty for this privilege to stand before you. This vision was birthed about 3 years ago, but last year we had the first Ayikaole Day celebration. And it comes to our knowledge, the importance of education. And we brought the right person, the right Royal Father. You are equally privileged for Kabiyesi to be the one that will first of all talk to us on this issue. But I want to assure you all that we will do all we can within our power to help those who are ready to learn, those who are ready to study. We're ready to do scholarship, we're ready to do a lot of things, and God helping us. At the end of this lecture, we're going to discuss with individual school principals, so they're going to give us the list of their best of the best that we can assist. God will help us in Jesus' name.
At this point again, we will not waste much time as we'll bring onto the podium His Royal Majesty of the King Sunday Amosinga. He will be coming to talk to us on the importance of education. I will only invite you to do two things. The first is to open your heart, open your mind. This lecture is going to benefit the young and the old. It will open the eyes of the young and the old, and it will show to everyone the importance of education.
He is an academic par excellence. He lived most of his life molding lives. He's turned around lives of people. He has touched lives and they will never remain the same. He has built men and women in high places. He is a trailblazer. He is the pace setter. He is generous in
our Royal Majesty. Princess Oluyemi Egbajuwa, the regent of Ayikaole Kingdom, the high chiefs, the honorees, eminent personalities here present, youths and students, gentlemen of the press, it is a thrill of pleasure to be here today to rub minds together and discuss about ways to further development of this Ayika community, to further development of this Ayika development. On this note, I have to appreciate God, who is King of Kings and Lord of Lords, bringing us here together, bringing her Royal Majesty on the throne of his ancestors, and for the unity, peace, development and cooperation that she enjoys from the community. May God bless you all. Moke and our Lord, you. I say, Moke and our Lord, you bigger, bigger. Moke and our Lord, Moke and our students, Moke and our Lord, you. And you can't help it. And you took out. That's what you are now. Oma, you can ask the president. As a governor, permanent secretary, federal state, as a director, as a minister's ambassadors, honorable senators, as a part of the Lord's Senate, like after the president's Senate, as the honorable and House of Reps, after the speaker. If do not get anyone who are, you are wrong, you can't keep it for you, keep it for you, just for you are. When I received the invitation to come here today, I was skeptical because I thought perhaps I may not have the opportunity to be present, and it is not my characteristic to send somebody to come and help me to deliver my message, because only Roger de me, a cabo junior. I bet I must do it. A cabo junior. With our lodger, what on the cacao jade? As a mother from what I'm water. But when I get better, not a calorant and a bay. What about the young people who want water? Well, I won't get it. We need to go to Jai. So the topic I received to be delivered today is the role of the importance of education to community development. But looking at the topic, I said perhaps the role, the importance, they are too common. But I'm going to speak and talk about the same thing, but I've changed the topic to the same idea between education and community development. That is what I'm going to speak on. Because the topic, the role of, or the importance of education in the community development, the role, the importance, is to maintain common and to simplistic. So the topic I'm going to talk about is the synergy between education and the community development. You look at Akwae Kingdom. Akwae Kingdom. Introduction. Nelson Mandela was a man who knew the importance of education. And he was once said that education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. That world, you can change that world to Ayeka only, to Nigeria, to those six, to your own community, to your family, and to yourself. Again, Nelson Mandela is a man who cherished education a lot when he was alive, and he was once quoted that education is the most powerful weapon to instrument, equipment, which you can use to change the world, which you can use to change your society,
your community, your life, your family. The main goal of education is to give tools to improve our health and economic opportunities so that the whole society can improve its quality of life. The essence of education is to bring about change, meaningful change, desirable change that will enhance living. And to enhance living starts from health, because health is wealth. Health is wealth. And the other thing on wealth this time around, not on economy, is because a healthy man is a wealthy man. A healthy man is a wealthy man. If you are not healthy, you can't, nobody will employ you. If you graduated with a first class position and your head is not sound, your knowledge, your intellectual will be useless because your head will not allow you to use your potentialities, your talents, your gifts to contribute to the family or to the community. So health is the most precious things that people cherish. And then you can get improvement on your health through education. Apart from health, we talk about economic opportunities, in terms of employment, in terms of creativity, to create job opportunities, to be employers of labor. So you need to have sound health. So health and economic opportunities are riches. They go by passion. For a country such as Nigeria to be the world focus of high poverty rates, despite it is one of the world's largest economies, and the robust tourist industry shows that its education system is very, very in low end. That is inexplicable low. When you look at Nigeria today, you say Nigeria is the giant of Africa. It's the economic giant of Africa. When you talk of population, yeah, number one. Economy, yeah, number one. But according to the world indices about poverty, Nigeria is ranked among the 10 poorest nations of the world. When it now comes to health, that is, Nigeria, the environment is unhygienic and is second to the worst in the whole world in terms of open defecation. That shows that our education has not improved our life, our environment. We have many universities, colleges of education, polytechnics, institutes of agriculture, college of agriculture, grammar schools, comprehensive schools, national college schools, name them, there are many. But despite all these numerous higher institutions, national primary schools, secondary schools, colleges of education, and the polytechnics, the whole world is looking at us. Yes, we have oil, we have tourist, you know, potentialities. We have the land, we have the forest, we have the people, we have education. But the education that we have, that means our lifespan to be below 60. Is that education? Whereas in US, the lifespan or expectancy is about 70 years. You get to US, they live 100 years, 80 years. Jimmy Carter is still alive. Their past, present, they are still alive. Because they have improved health services, improved health delivery services. They have education. And they translate their education into realities, not in theories, not in policies. More than half of the population is suffering from illiteracy in Nigeria, numeracy, and the dynamics of education. Community development should start by ensuring strategic educational programs where community members of all ages can advance their education, health, self-confidence, and better their quality of life. Education reduces poverty, boosts economic growth, and plays a key role in human, social, and economic development. In fact, investment in education yields significant development benefits. If you look around here, definitely the people in this room, in uniform, they are students. They are learners, that they are not educated. They are still learning. Abi?
Yes.
If you look directly to my front, I can see that they are students too. They are learners. They are not yet educated. But so they'll be educated. Now you look at the youth. Early you can point out four or one or two or three people that is not sleeping together. Then looking at the ships, I look at here, maybe one or two. They are all educated because they went to primary school, some went to secondary school, some went to colleges of education, polytechnics, institute of colleges of agriculture, and even universities. Is that what we call education? This will take me to the definition or interpretation of education. Many education experts have defined education from their various professional perspectives or interests. Some see it as a certificate or degree gained by schools and universities. So anybody who goes to school, secondary school or university, polytechnic, NCE, they say it's certificated because they are certificated. So if you are a primary school holder, you say, I am educated. I have a primary school living certificate. So you are an educated person. If you go to secondary school, maybe at best you have 9 credits or 8 credits, distinctions. And in that distinctions, as you can say, yes, I am well educated. Only division one. A1 in English. A1 physics. A1. Is that what you call educated people? You go to university or polytechnic or NC, you have NC, you have ONG, HND, you have a first degree, maybe ordinary pass, maybe third class, second class, lower division, second class, upper division, first class honors. I say, first class, thank you. Is that what you call it, an educated person? So some people, these are the category of people they classify as educated people. In this view, they talk about increasing literacy rates and producing professionals in various fields. Man, engineer. Come on, let's go. You know, you're not going to take away. Oh, my baby. And yet, doctor, university of Adam, let's get it. Oh, carry, oh, my baby. Architect, surveyor, teacher, oh, my baby. Well, I'm a way new medicine. When we talk of education, maybe as we go on, we know the interpretation I attribute to it. Some see it as self-education. That is, education is seen as applications of knowledge, skills, competencies, and values to transform in the society and restore the true meaning of knowledge. Knowledge acquisition. Anything else is combined. Biology, A1. Physics, A1. Mathematics, A1. English, A1. On my way, if you will. Because only knowledge.
But let me tell you, I've been into education for the past 53 years. Primary school. After primary school, I went to modern school. After modern school, I went to teacher training college, Occupational Traditional Teacher Training College, ODIA, 1979 to 1982.
to be trained as a teacher. But I was not trained as an educated man. I was to be trained as a primary school teacher. I was not educated. But I was trained
even not as a teacher per se, but a teacher for primary school. Not in secondary school. Not in secondary school. Not in college secondary.
Will I consider myself as an educated at that level? No.
I proceeded. Say, will I limit myself to this education? What we are doing today, some people came to my village and they counsel us, they talk to us. You can go, you can do this thing. I never knew what all what I knew at that time was that after grade two, you go for your posting and you go and meet your headmaster, you see your co-teachers and with the promotion, you come and assistant headmaster, assistant headmistress, and later headmaster. Then with the 120 Suzuki, praise the Lord. 120. So those days, these are the days of the 120. Some of them who were more privileged, who could say they buy 125. Two Zalesas. When you see that, hey, so my dead master, you have to wear a master, literally, silence and must sit there, make you mean. But the book will be fully by 120 to book it. Educated. And because at that time, the brand of education they received was a total, all inclusive education. They were trained as a catechist, trained as a teacher. Counselor as a secretary to communities. Secretary in the palace, secretary of the communities. So the teachers, they play all the roles. Near Baden, Bashishabai, community, our secretary, Baba. Secretary, Tiamo, the Bobawa, Ibobawa, Asabawa, I want to go for it, Africa. Nishashi, I want to be only us. Tim Azobati, I want to be all the way, I will not say, no, for them, I will.
So teach and buy it. They are well educated.
But not only my own time. Yeah, but I want teachers to come out one way with the two standards. They are well educated. Because they were taught all the rudiments of life. And they contributed meaningfully to the development of the community. And those teachers should interpret. Those are for you. See, you also don't know what you're going to do. See, I've got a letter. You look at the letter, see.
And how does computer facilitate knowledge, skills, acquisition? Values. Because in education we have some core values. We have the pedagogy, the professional aspect of teaching. We have the curriculum content. That is, if you are going for law, for medicine, you have to undergo some experiences, planned experiences, for a duration, 4, 5, 7 years, and so on and so forth. Yes. Then, after the content, we have more of methodologies. And in the methodology,
three values, moral values,
good character. A just man without a good character is uneducated. It's manners. Nobody will employ him. And nobody will give respect to him. It has no dignity. It has no respect. So this is, then when you acquire this, you develop your potentials, your talents, then you acquire ICT knowledge and its applications. Then make friends, you socialize. Then you pay back to your community. So if you acquire knowledge, you acquire skills, and you acquire good character, you don't come back to your service, to your community to give back, you are not educated. So I put that on in the paper. Then community. The community is a group of people living together in an environment with common concerns of living, or a people with common cultural heritage, language and beliefs, or shared concerns.
The community can also be referred to a group of faith-based religions with common ways of life within an environment with shared responsibilities to solve their problems and enjoy common belief and social amenities. For example, the Ebola community is a faith-based community. It is a That is a community. So a community does not necessarily mean a town or a village. It could be an association. And in the cities, somebody can belong to different communities. For instance, if you are living in Surulere, Surulere is a community on its own. If they have CTA, even in Surulere, different CTAs, Community Development Association, in Surulere local community. But at the local government level, we can have your bread, all of them. So if you are living here in Surulere, you belong to CTA in Surulere, in your government, you can also belong to a faith-based community. Maybe you belong to the Christian Church of God. That is another community. By the time they go to the Church of God, that is the community. By the time they go to the church, it's a community. So an individual can belong to different communities apart from different associations. That is the way of a community. So community, in large cities, communities look at from the perspective of particular neighborhoods, where many people belong to more than one community. In this case, an individual can belong to a neighborhood community, a religious community, and a community of shared interests, all at the same time. In essence, relationships with either land of people normally define a community for every individual. The relationship with individuals, in form of association, in form of where you live, in form of faith, maybe Celestia, Church of God, all of them in Nigeria, they will be meeting. You have a district, they will be meeting. So the district is a community. When you go, you are an Nigeria, you belong to a Nigeria community. But when you go to the Celestia community, why they are working with you? District, Celestia district, and everyone is a district. District, so the district by the time you come from different churches to come together, you are a community again. Okay? Community of Celestia, organizations of CDAs, associations, clubs, NGOs. Finally, conflict resolutions. Because without peace, there will be no unity. Without peace and unity, no development.
Committee, only Yata, Yata, at a level of it. We are for a major Nandela committee, Dundu, on ne peut pas faire le on ne peut pas faire le cap on a tout bon, avec Jalan, mais on va faire ça. On va faire ça, mais on va faire ça. On va faire ça, mais on va faire ça. On va faire ça, mais on va faire ça. On va faire ça, mais on va faire ça. On va faire ça, mais on va faire ça. On va faire ça, mais on va faire ça. On va faire ça, mais on va faire ça. On
Ni wa jere la ruga ni wa jere
on dit Macao Chan. Mais je vais le mien.
Ah,
We are here at the Palace of the Lumuri of Ayika, the venue of the Ayika Ule lecture titled Synergy Between Education and Community Development, delivered by Oba Professor Sunday Amusinga de Kalaswe of Apoiland. Of course, the guest lecturer, Professor Amusinga, here tried to draw the nexus between education and community development. The lecturer also examined the challenges facing education in Nigeria. In his speech, Professor Amusinga actually made it clear that it is quite possible for people to be learned and not educated. That the whole essence of being educated is the educated person's ability to be able to give back to a society and to be able to contribute positively and proactively to the cause of community development.